All right, so how do you draw this die with 20 sides? So again, it's three rectangles that have a height of 10 millimeters and a width of 16.8, centered at the origin. So you select sketch, select a plane. There's three planes. There's the front, the right, the top. So I'm gonna select the top. So I selected the front plane, and then I'm going to draw that rectangle. So I select the create rectangle, centered rectangle, click on the center, and then I'm going to draw this rectangle so that it's 16.816.18, and then the other one is going to be 10, and then I enter on the keyboard, and there it is. So that's my first rectangle. They ask you to set it up like that, where it's 16.18 with the height of 10. Then the next rectangle, now check this out. The next rectangle, I'm gonna move this over this way. It's gonna be on the right plane. So I'm gonna finish the sketch. It's gonna be on the right plane. And it's gonna look just like similar to this one. Go back to the front. It's going to look similar to this, except it's going to be set up instead of, we call this, there's portrait mode and landscape. This looks like a landscape mode where it's a lot, the length is longer than the height, right? So the other one's going to be in portrait mode where it's going to be taller. So I'm going to rotate this around, okay? And then I'm going to go create a sketch, click on the right side, and then I'm going to make this sketch 16.18 tall and 10 wide. So again, create. Well, that didn't work. Let's try it one more time. Let's go to not a solid. I didn't want solid. I want create. Wow, that's weird. What happened there? Create a sketch. There it is. Wonder why that wasn't showing up right. Is that on the... It's on the toolbar. Okay, there we go. And then I'm going to pick a rectangle, center point. Click here. And now this is going to be taller. So this is going to be 10. And the other one's going to be 16.8. Perfect. Finish the sketch. So now I've got two sketches so far, and this is what they look like. So it's looking good. Looks exactly the way it should look on the diagram that's set up on Google Classroom 7-9. Now, there's one more sketch, okay? It's going to be on the top plane, and that one, if I'm taking a look at it from the front view, it's going to be similar to the right view. All right, I can do that, where it looks more like a portrait mode. So here we go. Create sketch. I got to pick the plane first. Pick a rectangle. Over here on the right side, I'll pick the center. And this is going to be 10. And this will be 16.18. I think that's right. Yeah. All right. Finish the sketch. And let's go back to home. So is that the view that I'm supposed to have? Yep, it matches exactly the orientation of what I see on the directions. Now, what do you do with these rectangles? They have corners. These corners will be used to draw planes. Now, what's a plane? Well, a plane is a flat surface. And in geometry, you have to have three points that are not on a line. They're called non-collinear, three non-collinear points. Those three points are used to draw a unique plane. And then from those planes, we're going to draw the triangles that are equilateral triangles. That means they have the same length of 10. Okay? So how do you draw a plane? Well, you go over here to where it says construct. And then there's an option that says a plane through three points. Now, my font is awful small to look better on the video. But clicking that option, then you select the endpoints. There's one there, the corners. Then you select the corner down here. One there, there's one here. There's your plane. Kind of got an angle. Choose OK. Now your next step is to take that plane and draw a triangle on it. Connecting the vertices of the triangle at these points, the three points that were used to draw the plane. That's easier said than done. So I'm going to go to Create, click on the plane, go to the Line tool. Now, as I look at this, it's kind of weird. I can't really tell what's going on. So I'm going to rotate just a hair, Shift, click down on the wheel. So about right there, I can see what I want to click on. These endpoints, these corners, vertices, and then that origin. Now, that's one of the key features is when you draw this plane, it's going to come up with an origin. So always start there. And then what I do is I notice that these endpoints aren't activated. If I take a look, I can't activate them, but that's okay. I just kind of click near them. And I come back over here, click near this one, and then I go back to the origin, double click. So there's my triangle, but it's not connected to those endpoints, those cornered vertices that I used to draw the plane. So what I do is I go to the coincident tool right there and I select it. And then I click on the endpoint there. It's activated right there. See it? See it? Oh, I clicked on the line. Let me undo that. Go to the coincident tool. I want the point. Right there. Click on this point. There we go. It snapped into place. So here looks like it snapped onto the line, but that's okay. I can fix it. We're going to just click on this point right there. Click on this endpoint right there. Snap it into place. And there's your triangle. Perfect. Now, what they want you to do is once you create that sketch, go to Finish. And then click on the line segment so it turns blue. Left click. In the lower right-hand corner, it says a length of 10. All of these sides should be a length of 10. Click on the other side of the triangle. It should be 10. It is. And the final one, that's 10. So that's how you know that you drew the triangle correctly on the plane using these three vertices. So that's one. You've got to do this 19 more times to have 20 triangles that form these 20-sided dice. So you start over again. And what I'm going to do is, because it's smart to use the triangle that you already created, I'm just going to rotate around this way. And I'm going to use this endpoint and then these three points here to create the next triangle. Now, the directions ask you, once you create the triangle, it asks you to make a surface from this triangle right here. That triangle there wants you to make a surface. So how do you make a surface from the triangle? Well, across the top here, there's a surface button. See it? There's also mesh, sheet metal, plastic, utilities, all kinds of neat features. We're using the surface feature. And then from there, there's the patch. What a patch does is it creates a surface by closed boundaries, by using closed boundaries. And what's a closed boundary? Well, a triangle is closed. So it's got three sides. They're connected at the vertices, and it's closed. It's like a fence, right? So I selected the triangle, go to here, and it knows I selected that on patch. So that's called the patch. It knows this opens up. It says, hey, you selected that profile. You've got enable chaining. That's good. It's a new body. Choose OK. Now that changed colors. it's a kind of a grayish color, and if you rotate it, it turns kind of gold. So there you go. I got to do that 19 more times. So now I'm going to go back and create a construction plane. Now what I did, and I think it's a good thing you do this, when you go to plane through 3 points, there's three dots on the right side. Select pin to toolbar so you no longer have to constantly go down to that drop-down menu to find it. Just pin it to the toolbar and it shows up right here as an icon. And that's way easier. So I click on the icon. I'm going to select this endpoint, these 2 points here, and there. There's my plane. Perfect. I go OK. Go to sketch. Now I'm going to draw on this plane that I created. Make sure you select the right one, otherwise it's not going to work. Go. Now we go to the line tool. I'm going to rotate. Perfect. Select the origin. And then as I draw these line tools, these endpoints don't activate. I'm not sure why. I'm just going to draw this out. Double click back on the origin of the plane. Perfect. Go to a coincident tool. Zoom in. Click that endpoint. That endpoint. Oh, wrong endpoint. Undo. Coincident. That endpoint. That endpoint. And perfect. Finish the sketch. Double check. Make sure it's right. 10. 10, 10, click on the surface of the triangle, click on patch, turns into a patch, make sure these are selected, what's selected, the enable chain and new body, okay, perfect. So now we're starting to create the 20 different sides. It's going to take some time though, okay, so that's the start. Good luck with that. Like I always say, study hard. Good luck. See you soon. Bye-bye.